biggest takeaways?
I thought it was really fun to play in a rink like Maine. Obviously, it's a great college experience, really loud in there. Student section's like right behind you, so I thought it was a good experience to play in a rink like that with adversity in terms of the fans against you and the atmosphere.
How have you seen yourself grow as a player from last year to where you're at now?
I feel like I'm just more comfortable. Confidence too is a big thing as a goaltender, and the older you get, you just feel more comfortable in that, and when the shots come, you know you're going to save it, and that's a big part.
The night that you got 50 saves, were you sort of counting in the moment as you're making all those saves?
No. I was just playing my game, getting ready for the next shot. In those types of game, you're kind of in just a flow. So, I was just getting ready for the next shot.
So many hockey fans have heard the expression of goalie standing on his head, but only so many have ever been able to experience. And I think it's fair to say that's what you were doing. What is it like mentally when you're going through this, 73 of 74 shots saved?
As I mentioned, you're just in a flow. Things just go your way. Sometimes you get a lucky bounce, and that's what it takes to have one less goal go in. So things just went the right way, and it's fun.
What was your reaction here that you were honored by Hockey East?
It was an honor. Individual awards are always great, but I was more happy about just getting the two wins for the team.
What does it do for confidence coming off a performance like that?
It's a boost, obviously. Playing well and getting wins, it's all stuff that helps get the confidence up, and then getting another good week of practice and getting back to work, it's all good for the confidence.
You guys have a big matchup this weekend against one of the teams last year who might have been one of the chippiest series and playoff games that you might have had. What are you expecting going into the series against Lowell?
I'm expecting a heavy game again. Probably a lot of traffic in net in front. That's something I noticed last year a lot. They got a lot of bodies in front, so that's something to look forward to.
So, hockey goalies are kind of their own breed. What's some of the best kind of chirps that you've been getting ever since you had this weekend?
That I've given or gotten? Well, after that main goal, obviously they're giving it to me a bit, saying I don't mess it up, stuff like that. But usually they leave me alone most of the time.
What was that bus ride back from the? What was it like the bus ride back from the most successful weekend that you guys have had under Coach Woodcroft's tenure at Hockey East?
It was good. It was light. People are happy. It was good conversations going on. Obviously, it was a long one too, so got quiet near the end. People were trying to sleep, but it was good. Good vibe in there.
How do you keep this momentum going?
I think we just got to keep doing what we're doing. Make sure to get a good week of practicing. Take pride in the small things. You can't get away from our game. So.
When Coach was talking, he was talking about how you don't have a typical major, that you're very much an academic, and you kind of translate that over into how you prep for the games. Do you feel that way? What do you kind of do to translate how you study for maybe school as the same way for the game?
Before games, usually I like to do a bit of homework, just get the mind going a bit. So, I guess that might be a bit unorthodox, but that's my routine. I don't know. It works for me, so.
What's your major?
Zoology.
What kind of homework are you doing?
A lot of labs. I got chemistry right now, so post-lab work, stuff like that. I'm taking French, too. That's my first language, so that's what I'm taking. It's a bit easier for me, so kind of stuff like that.
Yourself naming the periodic table in that when it's a little
bit No. No, chemistry's not on my mind when I'm in the nets.